Did it crash yesterday?
No, you already put it away.
One crash. Whiplash.
It'll be on YouTube. I thought it's a 550, but it's a frenzy.
Yeah.
50.
Something cheap to smack on.
Cool. A little hot today.
Very hot. Human. It's been a good time.
Shouldn't you be working on that? You're gonna fly that or what today?
Not today. I'm still waiting on my people.
Oh, what?
My people.
Oh, very nice, very nice. V-bar. V-bar into that baby?
Yes. That's right. V-bar.
Sick. Steve Campbell.
Hey, what's up?
What do you got for us today? Nitro Whippy?
Whippy. First flight after the crash.
Any secrets? Nothing?
Huh?
Any secrets?
Nah.
Stock set up?
Stock set up.
V-bar, of course.
Yeah.
expressions there? Looks like a secret.
Gotta find something. Why no canopy?
Huh?
Why no canopy?
So I didn't damage it like the first time I did.
I heard it.
It's okay now.
Yeah.
1600?
Nice.
How you doing?
Gobbler, gobbler.
Three minutes.
You got the steel pinion?
No. This is one of the very first kits. I need to do the upgrade. Oh. Because the teeth are getting pretty sharp. Yep. They're starting to wear out a little bit. Yeah. I need to get... need to do that upgrade.
I shave my head all the time.
It starts to get noisier. You can hear them start to clank together. Ellie directs that to stock, so I'm waiting patiently. That's a nice helicopter overall.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, I like it.
Crashed it yet?
Yep. I had the Commander 130HV speed controller, Scorpion, and I was running the BEC off of it. On the ninth flight, it just quit. The whole thing just fell. Oops. Fell right out of the sky about 150 feet up.
Uh-oh.
So, wrecked blades.
How much was it to fix it? It's not expensive,
not
right?
I spent the most expensive thing was a new set of blades.
Yeah.
I need a new canopy. Like a new canopy. But probably a couple $100.
Yeah. Good, good.
Yeah, tail boom is still good though.
Oh yeah.
For the most part, it was, pretty good crash. So then I replaced that with a Contronic, and I've been loving it ever since.
I shouldn't ask, but no boom strikes yet?
No boom strikes, no. I keep the blades real tight.
There are a lot of guys on YouTube that...
I know. Yeah.
You are the lucky one?
Yeah, I think so.
Without?
No boom strikes yet. No boom strikes.
Okay. Good, good, good. Is it Wesley? Is it Wesley?
Yeah. You going home already?
Oh my goodness.
What is this?
Is there a funfly that you don't go to?
Yeah, there is.
I don't think so. Maybe in Europe.
I'm trying, man. I could get A-Main to pay for this.
Oh yeah.
I'd have to have probably several drinks before I get to the airport. Several drinks at the airport to survive the 8-hour plane flight to Switzerland.
You got any new goodies? Any new helis?
I do. I don't have it with me. All I have is my picture.
Oh.
Electronic failure forced me to have my crash.
Oops.
You'll be ready for Earth. See? If you haven't gone to Earth, if you're going to Earth, you still have only one kid. It's like going to the Holy Land. I mean, that's the only place you go, spend 14 hours in one place, and come back and do it all again the next day. Your job actually is spending 14 hours. You give me a day off tomorrow? Because if I'm going to be here 14 hours, I'm not coming back tomorrow.
That's awesome. Awesome. I've never seen it before, dude. Never seen stuff like this.
The cars are
like, dude, this, like these guys said, that's when you get hot.
How much? I don't know. I'm contemplating. Kind of burnt out. Alright, this is the first one. It's a decent carbon from a... battery tray from the Rage 450 with two things of 3M tape and then two zip ties.
Battery, man, that looks good.
Oh, sure. And this is the other one. This one has, it's a little bit better. I got this with I kind of got a piece of carbon, drilled two holes into it, zip tied it twice, actually four holes. And then just did the same thing.
Awesome. And what's that for?
It's for the governor, because there's no mount. So I just kind of did that. Did you go and idle up after at the last part of that?
It was still only the second one, yeah.
So, running two, Futaba 255.
Higher one.
251.
The line servo wheels work with this?
Yeah.
Okay.
But I'm using the second hole in with Quick UK to get that 6 degrees of pitch in the Beast X.
Yep. Sweet.
14 degrees of pitch. And
OS-105.
OS-105? One with an MP7 and one with a power boost placement.
You notice the difference?
The MP7 has it's easier to get to that tuning spot from the factory setting.
Yeah.
With the power boost pipe, you have to run it a little bit leaner to get that power out of it. Like, from factory settings, I'm like on the high, like 3 clicks off, meaning to the lean. But yep. That I'm like yep. 5 or 6, around 5. It's a work in itself.
Very nice.
So, and awesome. Radix blades, and that's Magnum fuel.
So how many people do we have at the Funfly?
We came out with a total of 45 registered pilots here today at our first annual Central Connecticut Radio Control Club Heli Funfly.
Mm-hmm.
My name is Eric, and we're very happy about that. We look forward to seeing you next year.
Oh yeah, I'll be here.
All right.
I'll be here. Great weather.
A lot more fun next year too.
Good crashes today, great weather, music, hamburgers, a lot of good guys. Coffee, everything. Another one.
Oh, there's a boom right here.
Who's this one? Oh, I know who's this one. Oh, yeah. Where are you?
Yeah, there's,
he's right there.
Is that Derek?
What are you guys working on again?
He's filming your car.
Ben's trying to save money.
Jan, go away!
It's not that bad. Seriously, dude.
Leave a dying man in
here. Yeah, I saw you. Saw you right there in the grass.
What?
What happened over there? Was it you?
I dumped him. Yeah.
Yeah.
I stuck her.
The satellite wires, is that what that is?
You're good. Loosened up my craft.
Motor's going to be easy.
How do you like the Funfly?
Good. I like it.
Not bad, right?
Yeah.
We got some full-scale helicopters.
Yeah.
We got some mini helicopters. Mikado, of course.
The inflate is like
pop
you
out.
pull the trigger over there and it'll
inflate them
for emergency only.
They'll
come right out and open
that's
up
why
and
it's
the,
called a clipper.
So if you're landing in the water, like you have to land in the water
just for emergency,
like a fuel shutoff valve, huh?
These are drains for fuel drains, just to check your fuel.
I see.
You can see some of the, you know, where the power comes from the engine up to the belt.
Yeah,
they take the power off the flywheel up to here.
These are loose.
Uh-huh.
So part of it is engaging the belt, getting them tight.
Yeah.
So the power here then goes to the shaft, the tail rotor, and then it goes to the shaft of the transmission.
The main rotor.
Then up there.
So the belts are loose.
Right, well, they're loose because they're not driving.
And here's the coaster like gear right here, the slug clutch.
Limitations, everything has their limitations. Yeah. So the helicopter's not too forgiving, you know?
Something, yeah, it's a little
landing
hot.
Downwind is not good.
Yeah.
When things go wrong, they go wrong quick. You know?
Yeah, you haven't had anything go wrong when you're flying, man.
No.
Not really. Right
now. No, this has been good.
That's been good.
Yeah.
If you've got 70 knots, you can keep going.